Well, if you guys follow me on Twitter, you know I'm not exactly doing the best. I've got a head cold. I've got possibly the worst migraine I've ever had in my entire life. But with War for the Planet of the Apes coming out later this week, I figure it's probably a really good time, especially since I reviewed Rise of the Planet of the Apes last week, to talk about Dawn for the Planet of the Apes. So let's get started. So Dawn of the Planet of the Apes is the second film within the Planet of the Apes franchise about the character of Caesar, played by Andy Serkis. And in Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, humanity is kind of on its last string. It's been almost completely wiped out by the super virus. They're living in this bunker with barely any food, with a little bit of electricity, when they lose something really important. So they send a team led by Jason Clark and Kerry Russell to go get this thing back, and those two run into Caesar and his family. And now we have a film where Caesar and his family have to survive after being away from humans for so long. And just like my review for Rise of the Planet of the Apes, I'm not getting much into the story, and I'm definitely not getting into spoilers, because this film is a lot better if you go into it without knowing much at all. But what I will tell you is that this film steps it up in every possible way, and it does exactly what a sequel should do, very much like The Empire Strikes Back or The Dark Knight did. First of all, the stakes in Dawn of the Planet of the Apes are a lot higher than they were in Rise of the Planet of the Apes. In Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, it takes all the events that happened in Rise, gives it gravity, and makes everything matter. Also, Caesar's character arc is becoming more and more phenomenal. We know that in Rise of the Planet of the Apes, Caesar became the leader of all the apes. In this film, he is the leader still, but he starts having questions whether he is a good leader, whether he's doing what he needs to. And it doesn't help that he has one of his own Koba, played by Toby Cavill, very excellently, by the way, just going after him and kind of contradicting every choice that he makes. Caesar's trying to protect his family while also trying to make peace with the humans and every other responsibility that comes onto a leader's shoulders, and it's just a lot of pressure for him. Now let's move on to the human characters. Unlike Rise of the Planet of the Apes, I actually like the human characters in Dawn of the Planet of the Apes more, especially Gary Oldman's character. While I think every actor in this film that played a human, from Jason Clark to Kerry Russell to pretty much everybody else in this film, was great, Gary Oldman's character was the one that I thought had the most depth and was the most understandable out of all the human characters in this film. When all of this conflict is going on between the humans and the apes, Gary Oldman's character was the one that I felt had the most tragic backstory and really the most understandable one too. Also, I know everybody has talked about it till they are blue in the face, but you just can't help it. Andy Serkis's performance as Caesar just keeps getting better and better. Then there's the CGI and motion caption. It's quite the parallel, because as Andy Serkis's performance just keeps getting better and better as Caesar, the motion caption just keeps getting better with each film. There were so many times in this movie when I would be looking at these apes and I'm just like, that's a real ape. That's real fur. It's absolutely insane. But my favorite part about Dawn of the Planet of the Apes is very much what I said I loved about The Empire Strikes Back, because Dawn of the Planet of the Apes is more than a movie about apes and humans. It's about love, it's about friendship, it's about honor, it's about what you would be willing to do if you were put in a dire circumstance. And what all that means, guys, simply is this. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes is suit worthy. And once again, I just gotta give a big thank you to you guys, because I love this channel, I love these videos, I love making reviews, I love making character analysis, but honestly, this channel would not be the way it is right now if it wasn't for you. So thank you. And as always, it is what you guys say that matters. So have you seen Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, and what did you think of it? More importantly though, who's your favorite character in Dawn? Koba or Caesar? Leave a comment down below telling me your thoughts. And if you like what you've seen here and you want to see more, click right there and subscribe and become part of the fray of nerds who love cinema. You all have a fantastic day.